Maggie here, and today we're going to be talking about changing your ostomy bag for the very first times. It can be super scary, especially if you aren't used to looking at your stoma, because you're going to have to when you change your bag. And the fear of not being able to get it to stick right is also very overwhelming, because you don't want embarrassing leaks and you don't want to have to deal with it 50 times. So I'm going to talk about some tips for changing your bag for the very first time when you're at home and you are scared. The number one step to being able to successfully change your bag, and this is for newbies and the old timer, you know, warrior, not rookies, what am I trying to say? It's important to be prepared no matter who you are and how long you've had your ostomy. That's the point I'm trying to make right here. Being prepared and having everything set out in front of you before you start is just the best way to prevent any issues. You don't want to be bag off, hands in deep, and realize that your flange is nowhere to be seen. It's just not something you want to run into. So making sure that you have everything laid out in front of you, even if you put it out in order of use, that would be a great way to get yourself in the swing of things. Also, having an idea of what order you're going to use the supplies is also great to start. You want to know what you're going to be doing, what product you're going to be using next. You want to have that in mind. What kind of bag are you using? Are you going to need to connect the bag at some point, or is it just a whole one system, you know, one piece bag? All these things you want to keep in mind, just so you know what to expect when you're in the midst and you have nothing covering your stoma. Another tip, and this is something that I did when I first got my ostomy, was changing my bag in the shower. In fact, I remember sitting in the bathtub for hours because my output seemingly never stopped. Changing in the shower or the bathtub is a great way to prevent messes, because it's a super easy cleanup if you do happen to have a explosive stoma, such as myself. It's just a great way to do an easy cleanup. Preferably, if you are doing it in the shower, have nothing on from the waist down. That way, if you have a little outburst, you can just rinse off when you're all done. If this is not a possibility, if you can't stand in a shower, or you can't get into a bathtub or whatever, use a large towel. Get a big towel that you don't really mind what happens to it, and tuck it into the waistband of your pants. That way it's covering your legs completely. So if you do have a major output, it's not gonna ruin anything. You're gonna be totally covered. Another way to help with the output issue is to fold up a paper towel, and I've shown this in other videos, fold up a little paper towel and kind of tuck it underneath of your stoma. So if this is your stoma and this is the paper towel, stick it right under, because your stoma's kind of wet and the paper towel is dry, they tend to stick to each other. And you can just wrap that paper towel kind of around the stoma like that and hold it at the top. So I would hold the paper towel right on my stoma, and then I would be able to do whatever I needed around the stoma. Obviously, it would be great if we could prepare ahead of time and kind of know what our output schedule was going to be like, which later on is definitely a possibility. I tend to know when my stoma is going to have heavier output, because I know how I eat and all of that. When you have just had surgery, especially if you're on pain medications, your ostomy output is going to be funky. Opiates tend to make you more constipated, and also the fact that you're probably not eating like you normally would is going to affect how often your stoma is having output. Also, the type of stoma, whether it be a colostomy, ileostomy, it all depends on the type of stoma you have as to how heavy or how thick or how liquidy your output is going to be. And these are all things that you will learn as time goes on. It's just one of those things that for right now, you're not going to have a whole lot of control over. Some people do tend to eat certain foods to kind of block themselves up. I would avoid that, especially if you have Crohn's or ulcerative colitis, because you don't want to deal with a possible obstruction due to that. But it's just one of those things. Expect a mess. Like, that's okay, just be prepared for the mess. Using a mirror can also help you with seeing all the way around your stoma, especially if you have a protruding stoma. It's kind of hard to see that skin underneath, and it's always important to make sure it's clean and dry. So using a little handheld mirror if you are sitting in the bathtub or you're sitting on a chair can help you see the stoma while you clean. If you are later on in your journey and you have kind of learned your output schedule, and you don't necessarily need to be in the bathtub or have a big old towel covering you, you can stand in front of your bathroom mirror. That's what I do. I still do it to this day because I can't see under my stoma, so I don't know what's going on under there. I rely on the mirror to help me see. One thing that really, really helps, and not everybody has the opportunity to use this, is an extra set of hands, whether it be a friend, a significant other, a parent, a caregiver, whoever is willing to help you with this, because I know not everybody is, but if you have an extra set of hands to help you when you change your bag, that can make all the difference. I know that when I was starting to change my bag on my own, my dad would be sitting there ready with the flange, ready to place it on, because he could see better. He could see my stoma directly on, and I would be holding the towel and I would, you know, take it away real quick and he would slap on the bag. That's kind of how our system was, and it's just that extra set of hands can really help somebody who's struggling to get the bag on in time, especially if their output is kind of going a little bit crazy. And one final note is practice makes perfect. Don't be discouraged if you're going to put on your flange and your stoma just, you know, ruins the flange completely before you can stick it on. I had that happen a number of times, so I know what it's like. I would always prepare two flanges just in case one wound up getting ruined. Happened quite a bit. Or, you know, don't be discouraged if your bag only sticks to you for an hour. You know, as time goes on and you get more practice with it and your skin is healing and you kind of learn what works best and what doesn't work for you, your bag is going to stick longer and longer. It is a learning process and it takes a while. It can be really, really frustrating when you are trying to just go about your normal life, trying to become normal again after this, you know, sort of traumatic surgery, and you're having to deal with this. It's a pain in the butt. I totally get it. So just keep that in mind that it does take time. All right, guys, I hope that you enjoyed this video. Contact me at letstalkibd@yahoo.com, and I am able to be found on Facebook, YouTube, obviously. What else? Snapchat, Twitter, Instagram. I don't know if I said any of those already. My dogs are like distracting me over here. And if you guys want to be notified of my videos, just subscribe below. I think there's a button somewhere. All right, guys, I will talk to you soon. Bye.